Good day, students. My name is Akinbuyiwa Emmanuel. I welcome you once again to this multimedia tutorial class for SX2. I hope you all are staying safe and you are following the rules and regulations being set aside by the world, by the government. I pray soonest all this pandemic will be over and we will come back to what, to school, so we can continue our class. Today we are starting with something quite different from what we have been doing earlier, but something very simple, and I would like you to listen attentively, take your pen and paper, and let's set the ball rolling. Today we are going to be dealing with internet basic terms. The internet basic what? Basic terms. Like I said again, the internet basic terms. Now, before we move to the internet basic term, before we start the class fully, I would like us to look at our lesson objective for today. At the end of this lesson, you should know and be able to state some internet basic words, basic terms. That is to say, you should know some of those terms, some of those words you use in the internet world environment. Like I said earlier, we are going to be considering internet basic words, basic terms. So, because of this class, we are going to be dealing with some of the common basic words, basic terms. So I would like you to listen attentively and let's set the ball rolling. Now the first thing we have to consider today is AVI. AVI. AVI simply means audio video interlinked. Audio video interlinked. A Microsoft Corporation multimedia video format. It uses waveform audio and digital audio frame to compress what animation. Now when we talk about AVI, they are just a multimedia video format. Like we all know, we have a lot of music or video formats. We have MP3, we have MPEG, we have AVI, and so on and so forth. Each of them comes with different compressing qualities. Each of them differs in terms of frames and what, and bits. Each of them differs in terms of what animation being applied to that particular video. So basically, the AVI means audio video what interleave. It is a format that was being designed by what, by Microsoft what Corporation for multimedia video what video format. The quality of AVI video is quite higher than your MPEG or your MP3 or MP4 format. AVI, audio, video, what? Interleave, basically to compress digital or digital video and what? And audio. The second one we are going to be considering there is what we call bandwidth. Again, bandwidth. This is one of the common terms we are familiar with. The capacity of an electronic line, such as communication network or computer channel, to transmit bits per seconds. Now, when we talk about bandwidth, we are talking about the capacity of an electronic device or communication network to move information. That is to say, how many information can your computer move over the network, either per minute or per what, or per second. We call them bandwidth. Virtually all our network provider has various bandwidth being given to the what, to the users, and each of them comes different speed and different quality. So your bandwidth will determine how fast your internet connection works. If your bandwidth is quite slow, the tendency is there that your communication on the internet while using the computer might be low, might not be as effective as planned. So therefore, good bandwidth are always required to enhance better capacity and better video and audio quality. So the capacity of an electronic line, such as communication network or computer channel, to transmit bit per watt per second, that's BPS, bit per second, some might be KPBS, that is kilobyte per watt per second, some might be MPBS, that is megabyte per watt per second, that is some might be able to move billions of information per second, some might be able to move millions per watt per second, and some might be able to move kilo per watt per second. It depends on your what, on your bandwidth and your bandwidth. That is why you cannot compare your 2G with your 3G. You cannot compare your 3G with your what? With your 4G. You cannot compare your 4G with your what? With your 5G. They have different what? Different bandwidth. That gives you better output. That gives you better what? Better result to what? To play with. Next thing you're going to be looking at is called bookmark. Again, bookmark. Now, bookmark is a way of storing your favorite site on the internet. Well, this is common when you are working with your browser. You have to bookmark this site, bookmark this, bookmark that. Is a way of storing your favorite site on the internet. That is, the site you like visiting, the common site you visit regularly. You can bookmark what? You can bookmark them so that next time you will not need to type the address of the site again. You just need to click on what you have bookmarked, and immediately it will link you or direct you to that particular site. We call that bookmark, a way of storing your favorite sites on the what, on the internet. Then another one is bitmap. This is common for those who are into graphics. A bitmap is a representation consisting of rows and columns. Now, when we talk about bitmap, every image, either PNG file, either JPEG file, or any other format, are in form of what? Bitmap. Basically, bitmap simply means what? Dot. Every picture you have on your computer consists of what? Of dot. Every video you have on your computer consists of smaller dot. The smaller the dot, the quality, the sharpness of the resolution you are going to get. So basically, when we talk about bitmap, we are talking about what? About dot. So a representation consisting of rows and column of what? Of dots of a graphic image in a computer, what? In a computer memory. Is that called what? Bitmap. Is all called what? Bitmap. Another one is bit. Bit. Bit stands for binary digit. That is O's and what? And one. Bit stands for binary what? Binary digit. Like you all know, the smallest information your computer can store is what? Is bit. B-I-T-S. Binary. A byte is made up of it's what? 8 bits. A byte is made up of 8 what? 8 bits. So 8 bits is equals to 1 what? 1 what? 1 byte. That is the smallest information your computer can store. That's why we say computer work with O's and 1 and 1. So when we talk about bits, we are talking about what? Binary. O's and what? O's and 1. We are not talking about letters. We are not talking about pictures here. We are talking about numbers, and the two numbers involved is O and what? And one. Then we have another one there, which we call the what? The MPEG. Again, MPEG. MPEG simply means Moving Picture Expert what? Expert Group. This is also another format of a what? Of a video. Quite different from the what? AVI. It has a lesser quality compared to your AV high. So the standard there, or the meaning of that, is Moving Picture Expert what? Expert Group. These are committee of people, organizations that come together to develop a format that can be used by their software, by their programs. We call them what? MPEG. So MPEG simply means moving picture as part of what? As part of majority of your picture are always what? MPEG. Moving picture as part of what? Group and the consist of what? Dot. Otherwise known as what? Bitmap. And that one is blog. This is quite common. We all know in the KG blog, this blog, and dash short and dash log. Log scripting allows someone to automatically post information to what to a website. Basically, we can simply say a blog is just like a mini website. A blog is not as robust, it is not as complicated as a site. So a mini site, a mini website is all due to as a blog. Every company has a site. If you don't have a site as an individual, you can have a blog, a mini site where you can where people can come in to see the content of what you have to what to offer. We call that blog. You can make a lot of money on it, and you have some free, companies online that can offer you a free blog. Some you pay just a little or token, and you go live. People can come into your site to assess their information if the need what arises. So blog is just a mini website. It's not as robust, it's not as elaborate, it is not as complicated as a website. And now on this chat. Chat is another common term we use in the internet. When we talk about chat, we're talking about real time. Synchronous text-based communication via computer. That is you discussing one-on-one with somebody online and the person is responding to you directly as if you are busy sitting together. It's all called a chat. We all know the issue of before we understand the issue of Yahoo chat room before and so on and so forth. We chat with our WhatsApp, we chat with our To-Go, we chat with our Telegram, we chat with our this, we chat with our that. He has real-time communication using a computer, as if the person is what it is present. Just like a WhatsApp now, you can do your video call and likewise you can chat by sending messages, either text, numbers, picture, some of you use emoji to chat. So chat simply means real-time discussion via the computer. Then number nine there is domain name, a method of identifying computer address or addresses is what we refer to as a domain name. The method of identifying a computer what address is what we call a domain name. A method of identifying computer what address is what we call a domain name. For example, Godforce School has a domain name, and that is www.godforceschools.com. So if you're looking for information about Godforce Schools online, you go to their domain what? Get their domain name, go online, type it there, and you will be directed to that particular site. We have another one we call the DPI, that is dot per inch. The way the resolution of display and printing is what is measured. Your printer or your resolution of the computer is measured in DPI, dots per inch. The smaller the dots, the better the quality of picture, the better the quality of output you will have on your work, on your screen. We call them dots per inch. Likewise, also printer quality are being measured in DPI, dot per inch. Then we have the FAQs, that is the frequently asked question. A list of questions and answers to your screen product and troubleshoot work problem. These are when you go to a particular site, then you will see their FAQ there. Those are questions that people have asked, common questions people ask. Like, for example, if you go to Gmail, you might see questions like, how do I reset my password, for example? How do I change my profile picture? How do I set my phone number? How do I do this? How do I do what? How do I do that? These are frequently asked what? Asked questions. They use on the what? On the internet. FAQ what? QS. Virtually every site has a FAQ what? FAQS. So you see FAQS, that is frequently asked what? Question, list of questions people ask when you visit a particular site. I mean, common questions, not questions that are very scarce to come by. Common what? Common questions. Then number 12, that we call a firewall. When I'm talking about firewall, we are not talking about your wall on fire. The name firewall derived from the term for a barrier that prevents fire from what? From spreading. Basically, that particular software, that particular program or application that secure your what? Your computer from what? From intruder. From outside, from having access to your system remotely, is all called a firewall. It's just like a sheet that secures your computer whenever you're browsing, whenever you're using the computer. They make sure no hacker, they make sure no intruder, they ensure no virus comes into your system. They shield your system from what? From malicious what? Damages. Use what? Firewall. Firewall, they're just a sheet to protect from external aggressions. Then we have the FTP as number 13. That is what we call the file transfer protocol. A software to receive, upload, or send files, text, picture from one computer to another. That particular thing that allows to move files from one location to another on the internet is all called the FTP, the file transfer protocol. They allow to move your file, it might be audio, it might be video, it might be text, it might be picture, any form of text over the internet. What makes that possible is your FTP, your file transfer transfer protocol. Again, FTP, the file transfer protocol, allows to move files from one point or one place to another. Over the what? Over the internet. Then another one there is the home page. Basically, if you visit a particular site, the first page that you're going to see on getting to that site is all called home page. If you go to Godforce school site, the first you're going to see there is you're going to see the picture of Godforce and some other vital information. The first page that appear on a particular site is all called home page. So I call what home page. So the first page that appears when you visit the site, we call that home page. So every site must have an home page. Every blog must have an home page. Your e-commerce site online, they have an home page. Facebook have an home page where you put in your password and what and login. Google has an home page where you put in your password, your username, and what. And some other thing, I do login home page. Then another one is the HTTP. Again, HTTP, the hypertext transfer protocol that enable HTML document to be read on the internet. Without the HTTP, you might not be able to read text on the internet. What makes that possible is the HTTP. The hypertext transfer was transfer protocol. That's why every at the front, if you check your address bar in your browser, the first thing you're going to see there is the HTTP /www.godforceschools.com. It allows to read the content of what you have on that site. HTTP. Then another one there is the internet. A global network of thousands of computers, network linked by data lines and wireless work system. Like you all know, the internet is just a global communication, a global connection of different systems connected together to share what information, to share what, to share resources. Like we all know now, we are in the era of what, of internet. Rather than sit in a particular place and have access to a particular information at a particular place, at a particular time. What makes that possible is what is the internet, the international network, the connection of different computers working together as what, as an entity. Then we have the IP, what? IP address. IP address simply means internet what? Protocol. The number or name of the computer from which you can send and receive information. Every computer on the internet has an IP address. So if I'm to locate a system on this internet, I will need to locate through the IP address. Your phone also has an IP address to locate your phone over the world, over the, just like your house address. So your house address of your computer or the internet is what referred to as what, the IP, what, the IP address, internet protocol. Then another one there is the Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi simply means wireless what, fidelity. Wireless what, fidelity. This is one of those common ways now we connect to the world, to the internet, through the hotspot. For example, wireless simply means wireless what, fidelity. They can go a few distance between each one, between each other. It is a program or a set of instructions that have been coded into your devices that can connect to an external network when you have the password. They call it wireless, Wi-Fi, wireless what, fidelity. It is a device that is enabling us to share information, move information, access information all around. So I don't need to sit with a particular device. If I can browse, I can hold my hotspots down, move around the house, move around the school, move around the building with my wireless, and I can still access what, the internet. Now what we are saying is there are a lot of basic terms that we use in the world. If you go to the hospital, they have the terms. If you go to the schools, they have the terms. If you go to the Lord Chamber, they have their word terms. If you go to the church, they have their word terms. You see the army, the police, the air force, the navy, government, politicians, they all have their terms, how they relate, the kind of words they use. So the same thing happens in information and communication with technology. We have our own terms. We have how we relate to people. We have how we talk, how we discuss, how we liaise with one another. Using our words, using the various terms, which I have mentioned some of them for you. There are thousands of them, but I'm only limited to what you have on your screen. If you go online, you can have access to a lot of information, Google them, and you see a lot of basic terms. You can check a text rules for further information, or you send a mail directly to me through the WhatsApp platform or through your Twitter, and I will be willing and ready to do what? To assist you at work at will for further clarity. I think you can go online again and just get more information about what, about that. I hope you enjoyed this brief audio and video class. I will implore you to keep enjoying your day, keep reading your books, and keep preparing for what, for the exam, and keep staying what, keep staying safe. Follow the laid down rules and regulation of what, of the government. And I pray soonest we shall all be free from this pandemic. Once again, I remain Akinboyiwa Emmanuel. God bless you and have a nice day. Bye.